An early morning rescue at Sacred Falls has some people asking how much the public is paying to foot the bill. Not just today, but whenever people go where they're not supposed to, then get stuck. At around 1 o'clock this morning, the Honolulu Fire Department got a call about a stranded hiker at the falls.
We had ground crews that made voice contact with the victim at about 4 a.m. He was told to stay in place and that we'd come back with Air One at first light.
Well, we just went hiking and then one of my friends just went pretty much bushwhacking. Ended up like probably right along that ridge over there.
Sacred Falls has been closed and off limits for nearly 15 years. No one should be there. So should the lost hiker be held responsible for paying the rescue bill? We wanted to know, and Jai Cunningham is getting you answers.
There are signs that clearly mark the Sacred Falls State Park is closed, off limits. One of the four young hikers who left on a hike yesterday admits he knew it was off limits, but went anyway, with one of the men eventually splitting off from the group.
All night long, we were just looking for him. Then finally this morning, the sun rose, and then we found him right along the cliff over there.
When he says we, he means the Honolulu Fire Department had to be called in with its rescue helicopter. We wanted to know just how expensive that can get.
Is there a ballpark figure as to how much it costs to try and rescue a missing hiker when Air One is involved?
So that's two companies plus the incident manager plus the helicopter. An average rate would probably approximate a close to $1,000 an hour for that group of responders.
That's several thousand dollars over the period of a few hours. Captain Selig says it is possible for HFD to try and recoup those costs, but it could come at a price.
We don't want to put up a barrier that prevents people from doing the best thing for their situation in a rescue that's a call for help as soon as you realize that you're in over your head.
Captain Selig says it's not that uncommon for people to voice concern when they're rescued.
They didn't call right away because they were worried about being charged and thought, well, I'll just suck it up and try my best so I'll avoid that penalty.
The stranded hiker and his friend were both cited by the Department of Land and Natural Resources.
The ticket, it's just a citation to not go back inside.
A petty misdemeanor, but it could carry as much as a $2,500 fine. Jai Cunningham, KHON2 News.